Look at that smile.
My name is Mady. I love people. Without people, without other people, what would we do? What would I do? There is need for people to feel love. I mean, go backwards, like when I was a little girl. My mother was very beautiful. And family was just like that. And I was very shy, very quiet. Stood by the door and waited for the time, you know, I mean, before we played it, stuff, waiting for it to be done. But the bell would go off, so I'd go back again. I mean, there was I knew that when I was young, I had a little boy and a girl that would come down the path and play with me, and then they would go upstairs to the father. Anyway, I really didn't get a relationship with God until I was probably in my middle 30s. So I worked hard and did a lot of drinking and partying and met a lot of bad people. And that's what I'm with. And I was almost killed many, many times. I've been shot at. I've been choked. I was put in a bag and towed, and he tried very hard to get in the car, get it up, just get it up in the truck. He wrote me from prison to tell me if he could have gotten me in the truck, he would have still killed me, and I knew that. But God, even though I wasn't saved yet, he saved me every time. I made downtown street of Stillwell like a street, the sidewalks. I was trying to get away from different guys, you know. And some was, you know, one of the guys, a friend of mine's husband, and I mean, I lived a real, real tough life. When I got tired, you know, I reached out to the higher power. And when I was in Stillwell, I started going to Oklahoma. I went to go into the church. And it was a Jehovah's Witness church. And then later on, another friend told me about this church. And I said, "Well, I'm going to have to go check it out." And Jehovah's Witness woman said, "Well, I wouldn't. There are witches down there. That's why I got to go check this out." And so I did, and that's when I found God. This woman was praying for me, and I could not believe that this woman was actually praying for me, and why would she do that? But she did, and it made me cry. She was trying to make me cry. After by the time I got here to Coweta, I had my go-go too, and I was still going to the bars, meeting the bad guys, and again, there was still more close to death situations. But I had to get to the point, you know, I believe it was Sister Karen's faith, I know it was. She said, "I want you to look at yourself in the mirror and see who you are. You need to love yourself." And that's true. It really is true. And I started growing and learning to know who I was, know just who I was to God. And it's so awesome, it's so sweet. It really is. I've seen many healings. There was a point in time in my life when my knees were bad. I couldn't walk. I would stand there laughing my leg because I couldn't move. And I told God that if he would heal me completely, that I wouldn't tell people of his love and his mercy and his grace that I've seen that. And I know about that. And it's our job as Christians and women of God to get out there and let the word out about God. There are so many people that doesn't know who God is. And it's very important that we do that. More now than ever. Because time draws short. Amen.
Amen.
But, I started growing, and I've seen this one woman, her belt was missing, and I laid hands with her on her and prayed for her. She had left her wallet behind her door in the apartment, and it came back. I seen this vehicle, or I didn't see the vehicle, but this woman said, "Meaning my car's gone," or no, it was truck. She said, "My truck is gone." And I said, "We're going to pray and believe that truck's going to come back," and it did. It wasn't a flame, it was a door missing, but it came back to work. I've seen my legs. Again, my back was so messed up. My one leg was shorter than the other, the legs came back. I mean, and I've seen my legs come out to me, the one leg come out to me, the other leg. I've seen a dying man who died of he was having a heart attack and he died and came back alive. God is real. And he's out there for you and he's out there for me. I want you to know that if you're out there online and you don't know God, and you've been going out and just having fun and drinking and stuff, and you feel lost and you feel messed up, and you just need help, I'm telling you to just look up, lift your hands. You know there God's there. And he's there for the broken in heart. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Lord. I've seen so many miracles. There was this woman, her child with Bert. And I didn't know this woman, but I didn't know this girl, she was like, just a young gal. And I hear her, it's just here that her, this other lady talking about this girl that her trailer burnt, and she was at Garden Walk apartment and she didn't have no clothes. And I didn't know what side that woman wore. But you know what God told me? He made sure I got the clothes that she needed. And so I found out after driving around tweeted where this woman lived. At Garden Walk apartment, that they do something. And I knocked on the door and I said, "What size clothes did you wear?" She's 18, that's I heard about your father and everything. So I gave you these clothes. Amen. I know what this here was about, but what today was about, but I our life. And we're supposed to let our life stop shining inside of her. That people would be drawn to God.
Amen.
And that's what we're here. We're supposed to be doing.
Yes,
I see that kid strength I know. At when I'm going to Walmart or give me a grocery store, I just want to see who I can smile at. Mm-hmm. You know, hoping that body of me will, they'll see that. That's good. It's all good. Mm-hmm. I remember one time, my baby girl, the youngest one, she was crawling and I couldn't walk. And I was crawling too because my back was really, really bad. And I had my husband's mother come over to take care of the kids and me. And I asked God, I looked at the TV, I seen this man healing this somebody that God was using him. And I seen God heal. And I said, "God's going to heal me."
Amen.
And he did in crawled with my baby. So, amen, amen. I love you all. I love all you girls. You're all special to me. You all have a peace heart, you know, my heart. You know, you just are. I don't know if it's been 20 minutes or 30 minutes, but I could go on and on and on.
It's up to you.
I thank you for your time.
Why don't you just pray for everybody?
Yeah, that would be awesome, wouldn't it? Lord, I just thank you for these beautiful ladies, Father God, and I thank you for this person, this out there, Father God, and listening to us, Father God, and hear God say, Father God, I see that you would draw me in, Father God. Bless your goodness, and Father God, and helpful, Father God. Lord, I thank you for these ladies here, and I thank you that they are my sisters, Father God. I thank you that, Father God, that today, that, Father God, you're completely given peace, Father God, about anything they've been going through, Father God. Let them just have peace. Let them feel your love, Father God. Your comfort, Father God, because you are the comforter, Father God. Give you all the glory to Christ, Father God. For all things in Jesus' mighty name. Oh, my, the Holy Spirit is so strong here.